actually been crushing it with these. We had four of them a couple weeks ago, and that's the last one that's left.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I've seen a lot more touring musicians playing on them.
Yeah.
Yeah, Strandberg's hot. You have any Abbasis?
No. We haven't been able. I don't know if they're.
I think they literally just make them and sell them. Like, yeah. They haven't done retail at all.
Yeah,
you know?
I don't think they probably don't need to. Yeah. You know? Yeah. The sales manager for Neural DSP was here yesterday.
Oh, cool.
That's the one I'm really excited about.
Oh, you're going to stock them?
Yeah, I think it'll be in a couple of months. I think Sweetwater still has their exclusive. I'll take it if you don't mind.
Nice. Oh, awesome. Shout out to Pitbull Audio. Yeah.
And whenever you guys are ready, I can show you.
We'll be right back. another super packed textural tune. The whole record was like a lot of layers and parts. And I kind of went really crazy with that. I felt like it was one of those things. I was just hearing all these guitar parts. Everything was very intentional. So it's a super layered, packed record. And that's why we're releasing actually it next week as instrumentals, because it's...
ripping at a very young age now, like default, like there's a lot of that. There was always some of that, but now it's like, shit, like it's like
shredders at like 12 and shit, right? Yeah. But anybody else play headless guitars and stuff? Or, yeah?
What? Adam Kiesel.
Oh, get out of here.
Hometown heroes.
No, I'm just kidding.
That's what I came for.
Kiesel are cool. Yeah.
Yeah, I'd always wanted one. I had like tendonitis issues, so I needed something like ergonomics.
Nice. Have you ever played a Strandberg? Or?
I've touched one. Yeah, they're a little bit, feel a little bit small. But
yeah.
I like them. They're
for the elfin race.
Yeah, I do love them. They're beautiful.
Yeah.
They're out of like my price range anyway.
So. Okay, yeah. Those Aristides, those are sick. Have you guys seen those? Do you guys carry those?
We don't, but I've had a couple come to the shop.
Yeah. Okay.
For dropping in different pickups and stuff.
They're, yeah.
Interesting.
Super cool, man. Yeah. The way they're using like a eco, like resin material.
Yeah, composite.
Yeah.
I don't even know. It's all science.
Yeah, it's all science-y.
Making guitars.
Yeah, and killer finishes and stuff.
Yeah, last one we had was like this sherbet orange color. It
yeah.
Really.
All right, so we'll do another one. Sometimes they existed for years before and they just finally were like ready to be finished. But yeah, it's a lot of just coming back. Like this song, for example, you know, if you look at, it's interesting, like even just talking on a guitar level, it's like the whole guitar song is built around, it's like a chromatic thing. It's these four notes. Something I didn't even realize till later. One of those things I was like, oh, it's so simple. It's such a simple tune. But I'm just like playing with those. Like a lot of these songs have that idea where you just take kind of a simple progression or just like these kind of, you know, changes and then kind of play them differently, right? You slow them down, you speed them up, you open up the picking, the phrasing, and then it kind of becomes an arrangement. So it's deceptively repetitious, but
it sounds in the context of like how it's arranged with the band and produced, it can seem way more complex, but it's actually a very narrow little piece of harmonic content that's just kind of evolving in deceptive ways, you know?
But yeah, I don't really have a formula, you know? I always have this almost a degree of terror after I finish a record where I just don't know if I'll have another song in me again, you know? It's like, and then sometimes I'm like, oh yeah, I can do this. I can write more songs. Like I have more songs in me. But you kind of come, at least for me, I come in and out of, it's a relationship with the music, because I don't want to just write to write. I write all the time, but I write because I have something to say. You know, it has to come from a place of like authenticity and wanting to like express something, you know, kind of get something out of you, right? But yeah, it's just like, I think it's, if you're, do you write riffs and stuff? Is that how you?
Yeah, are progression. You,
and melodies too, or?
No, like those are harder for me to write. It's just like, my more easy go towards like ideas and patterns and like repeat them until it like sounds unique or something. And then I can get stuck there a lot and not know where to go with it. But
yeah.
I get really happy